Morning to all of you. Today's topic is on sampling technique. In the sampling technique, we see a different types of films, such as solid films, as well as multi-technique films, as well as pressed or pellet films. These are a characteristics of solid, liquid, or gaseous sample. Let us discuss the sampling of solid, liquid, and gases separately. In last lecture, we have seen different types of radiation sources, as well as monochromators, as well as detectors. Now we see the sampling technique. First one is solid films, which is useful material and it can be deposited from the solution and cooled from melt as a microcrystals or a glassy film. This film generally produces a different types of crystals. That one is microcrystals or glassy film, which is glassy film like polymers, like resins and amorphous solid, which is then dissolved in a volatile solvent, which volatile solvent means that is chloroform and petroleum ether, etc. And after the dissolution in solvent, we get the solution, and this solution takes place on a rock salt plate which contains a rock as well as salt. And evaporate this solvent by a gentle heating. The care must be taken to free the sample of the solvent. This film produces a crystalline solid, which produces the scattering, excessive scattering, and this specific crystal orientation may give the spectra differing from those observed for randomly oriented particle, such as exist a mull or halide disc. In this technique, these techniques which has been ensured that the film is not too thick to pass the solution, and this technique is useful for rapid qualitative analysis, but becomes useless for carrying out the quantitative analysis. Second one is solid run-in solution. Here when the investigation solids are in solution, the absorption due to solvent has been compensated by keeping the solvent in a cell of same thickness as that containing the sample in the path of reference beam of double beam spectrophotometer. Generally, first point, we notice that solid may be dissolved in a non-aqueous solvent. No chemical interaction between solute and solvent, and also solvent does not absorb in the studied range. There is point number second, the solute and solvent does not produces the chemical interaction and does not absorb in the that particular sample study. A drop of the solution is placed in alkali metal disc and the solvent allowed to evaporate and leaving a thin film of solute, or the entire solution is placed in a liquid sample cell. If the solution can be prepared in a suitable solvent, then the solution is run in one of the cells for liquids. These methods cannot be used for all solids generally, because suitable solvents are limited in number and there is no single solvent which is transparent throughout the IR region. But this method is not for all solids, as the suitable solvents are limited and no single solvent is transparent through the IR regions. Which solution is used? Generally, solvent must be dry and transparent in the region of interest. This is the primary requirement. The solvent, generally a common pair, that is carbon tetrachloride or CS2, carbon disulfide. Carbon tetrachloride shows the free absorption at 1333 centimeter per centimeter, and a little absorption below 1333 per centimeter. solvent and solute combination, that react must be avoided. This is the important combination which can be avoided. Next one is Nozzle Mull Techniques. These mulls are prepared. Mulls means what? Formation of this glassy type of solution. This is called as what? Mulls, which can be prepared throughout the grinding a small amount of sample in a smooth agate mortar. This is the mortar. A mull of sample is pipetted or smeared into NSLDs. This one is what? NSLDs. And this sample is here pipetted on the NSLDs. Second NSLD is inserted over the first one. And this mull of sample is sandwiched between two discs. This is NSLD disc held together by a surface tension. Here the when infrared incident radiation is passed through the two disc which is sandwiched over one another, and this is the transmitted radiation, that is transmitted IR radiations. Nozzle during this absorption, IR absorption, the formation of carbon-carbon and CH which is present in hydrocarbon shows the IR band at 29, 15, 14, 62, 13, 76 and 17, 19 per centimeter. Next one is when hydrocarbon bands interfere with the spectrum, fluoroloop of hexachlorobutadiene may be also used. The use of both Nozzle and fluoroloop mulls makes possible a scan and essentially free of interfering bands over the 4000 to 250 per centimeter region. This region is also called as what? Fingerprint region. During this region, various types of functional group is actually present, and this technique produces to differentiate these types of groups. Multiple reflections and refractions of the particles are reduced by grinding the particles to size and an order of magnitude less than the analytical wavelength, and by surrounding the particles with a medium whose index of refraction is closer to enough, and this index of refraction is match. These techniques are also good for the qualitative analysis but not for quantitative analysis. The disadvantages of this technique is Nozzle is transparent in most part of the IR spectra, but it has a characteristic absorption of carbon-carbon CH vibrations at these types of wavelengths. This is a major drawback in using Nozzle for certain compounds which may have absorption region similar to Nozzle. Next technique was pressed pellet technique. This is a finely ground sample, solid sample, which is mixed 100 times its weight of powdered KBR. This mixture is pressed under a very high pressure, at least 25,000 PSIG, to form a small pellets, which is very fragile and transparent to IR radiations. This is one important one, pressed pellet technique. The powder sample, that is which contains KBR and sample, is introduced as shown, and then the upper screw A is tightened until the powder is compressed into the thin disc. After compressing the sample, one removes the bolts A and A dash and places the steel cylinder with the sample disc inside it in the path of the beam of IR spectrometer, and a blank KBR pellets of identical thickness is kept in the path of the reference beam. From this, we calculate the sample as well as what? That is blank. Why we use KBR means advantages over a Nozzle mull technique. KBR eliminates the problem of bands which appear in the IR spectrum due to mulling agent. In this case, no such band appears. So, these techniques is very important, press pellet techniques compared to what? Nozzle mull techniques. In Nozzle mull techniques, variable bands are observed and it is a very difficult to obtain or to analyze these types of bands. K-bare pellets can be stored for a long period of time. This is also a good advantage. As the concentration of the sample can be suitably adjusted in the pellets, it can be used in a quantitative analysis. The resolution of the spectrum of the KBR is superior to that obtained with MULS. The resolution means what? The formation of the bands, which is well resolved. This well resolved band, which we analyze easily, and formation of new types of compounds gives good results. The disadvantages of pellet technique: it always has a band at 3450 cm/cm from the OH group of moisture present. This one is very important. Thus, care must be observed in the investigation concerning the region of the OH band in the sample. Means, suppose we take one sample and it gives analysis of IR by using a pellet techniques. So we get one band that is 3450 cm/cm, and this gives a moisturized band, and this moisture contains the OH group. So this is the concerning about pellet techniques. This high pressure involved during the formation of pellets may bring about polymorphic changes in a crystallinity in the sample, that is inorganic complex, which may cause complication in the IR spectrum. This is also major drawback. This method is not successful for polymers. Means pellet technique is not useful for the polymers, because polymers are not pressed by pellet techniques, which are difficult to grind also with KBR. Next one is sampling of liquid. Suppose we have a sample of its state is liquid, then what should we do for the analysis of IR? First liquid at room temperature. This is the primary requirement. Rectangular cell made up of NaCl, KBr or thorium bromide, in which we placed a sample which contains NaCl, KBr and thorium bromide. Sample thickness should be 0.01 to 0.05 mm to give a transmittance between 15% to 70%. If a cell possesses good quality windows, flat and parallel, its thickness T in centimeter can be calculated from the following equation, that is 2T is equal to N divided by W1 minus W2, where the number of frings. Frings means what? Formation of different types of bands. This is called as what? Frings. Between wave numbers W1 and W2. That is successive fring. That is W1 and W2. The sampling of gases. The gas sample cell is similar to cell for liquid samples and made up of KBR, NaCl and so on. To compensate for the small number of molecule of a sample that is obtained in a gas, however the cells are larger. Usually they are about 10 cm long, but they may be up to 1 meter long. Multiple refraction can be used to make effective path lengths as long as 40 meters, so that constituent of the gas can be determined. In this sampling of gases, particularly it consists of cylinder gas or sometimes it contains metal. This is a closed at both the ends with appropriate window material and equipped with valves and stopcocks. The gas samples is put into a special cell, generally 10 cm to 1 meter. Generally 10 cm to 1 meter. This is a effective special case. And multiple reflection can be used to make effective path length and constant of the gas determined. So the reflection of the beam makes the reflection of the beam makes the effective path length several times longer than the gas analysis, which performs the IR, but the method is not commonly used because of its lack of sensitivity. Here moisture can be avoided. This is the major problem. Its strong absorption bands at 37.10 per centimeter and 16.25 per centimeter. That may interfere the analysis.